what's gonna happen when you face this, the most awesome force you ever saw. And remember, when you're messing with high voltage, you're messing with the best. Now don't you wish you had something like me?
My name is Matt Hardy, but I am formerly known as High Voltage.
Can you survive? I don't think so!
High Voltage obviously was the first persona or character as a professional wrestler. And the reason I selected High Voltage is because when I was 12 or 13, there was a time where I touched the light. Something was by a light socket, and I touched it, and I got shocked. And it like kind of knocked me back, and I was like, oh my God, that should have killed me. Why didn't that kill me? Maybe I can withstand electricity. Maybe I'm High Voltage.
Wolverine was my number one go-to back then. That was my Sting / Ultimate Warrior character.
High Voltage. Wait. Just wait until I get a hold of you.
Right now, we are standing in the middle of the Moore County Fairgrounds. And the Moore County Fairgrounds is approximately 13 minutes from the Hardy compound. We grew up big wrestling fans, saw WrestleMania 4, fell in love with the business, but that was the point where we were like, man, this is the coolest thing ever. These guys are living, breathing superheroes. This is what we want to do. And we had a trampoline and we built a ring around it on our own, and it kind of became like a cool thing in our little city and area. We had some friends that would come over and participate.
This is High Voltage.
And eventually, from doing this, word spread. Kenneth Morgan was a carny who'd worked in the fair business for quite a while and just did different things. And he had built a wrestling ring. And this guy said, hey guys, I know y'all wrestling on a trampoline and whatnot, but I got this real cool concept, and I'm gonna start doing some shows at fairs. And this guy said, what do you guys call your promotion? And you know, we're like, well, we were the TWF for like Trampoline Wrestling Federation. We said, okay, well, maybe we'll call it the TWF. And Bo, I'm telling you, I think this is gonna be the next big thing.
And we'd go out there in spandex and socks, and we were loving it, every minute of it.
The adrenaline rush to see the people cheer and boo and cheer, it's like, oh my God, so addicting. And like, once you get that taste of it, you're like, man, this is the coolest thing ever. I need more, I want more. Building. This was our dressing room whenever we had shows here at the Moore County Fairgrounds. It's funny, I can still vividly remember the camaraderie that we all had in this locker room. I just remember being in there, like we'd have three nights here back to back. Guys really weren't making money, but it was a bunch of guys who were passionate and had these goals of like making the professional wrestling business.
If matches were close too, like costume changes were really tough. Because, you know, there's times when, like, the music hits and people, your music's playing, which happened recently a while back, but your music's playing, your music's playing. Oh, God. It's just a sprint for life to complete the show.
From where this is to where the ring was is a football field. So it's a pretty far haul. And there would be times where, like, guys would have to rush back and they would have 5 or 10 minutes, they have to change to get into a different wardrobe to come out in another character persona. A lot of great memories here, a lot of fun. And really, it was like some of our earliest and some of our fondest memories of getting to live our dream. Sure, everybody wants to go to WWE, everybody wants to be on this huge platform, but like, in essence, we were living the dream right here. We were going out and we were entertaining people and we were evoking emotion. And that's why you get into this crazy, insane world of professional wrestling in the first place. So it was very cool. These are our roots, man. They're our roots.
Oh, wow. This is where it all began. You know, basically, the daredevil in me came out here. The people here were kind enough to let us put big nails in this post so we could get to the roof to jump off. The holes are still here where the other ones are. I just look at that. I think we had 4 or 6. We kind of had the jump to get up there.
It's very cool. The same pole that was here originally is still here, and it's still utilized. It's kind of like part of the show or part of the act in this day and age. It's cool. It's just like, for us, I think it's real neat that we were kind of the pioneers of starting this gig here, you know, and like it still continues. And I think it's still cool that young guys who are trying to like, you know, make a name for themselves in the business still come out here. And just to see that passion, that there's such a great purity to that passion. And it's amazing they're still doing that. And even just like this thing, you know, one of the original artifacts from the days of the Hardy Boys is still here and is still utilized. I think it's very, very neat, very cool.
It is time for a new dawning in the world of professional wrestling. And that ascending force goes by the title of High Voltage, almost like a godsend.
A funny story is, I was doing High Voltage, and like once we started building a little bit of a name and reputation for ourselves, we had a couple friends that were at WCW. And someone said, hey, send us some tapes and we'll look at it and we'll see if we can help you get a job or a spot down here to try and get your foot in the door. And we sent our tapes down and some guys watched it. They said, oh, these guys do some pretty cool moves. But I know there was one point where someone had watched these tapes and a new tag team, these two big jacked up guys came in and they were getting ready to put them on TV and start them, and they wanted to figure out a good name for their tag team. And somebody said, hey man, did you see that tape of that Hardy kid? His name's High Voltage. I mean, I'm sure that's not trademark or copyright. Let's just take that name. That'd be a great name for these two jacked up guys. And they debuted and came out on Nitro as a High Voltage. And I was like, what? And I heard legitimately from Chris Canyon, who later came to the WWE, that that name came specifically without a shadow of a doubt from the demo tape that I sent those guys back in the day.
I was even devastated, man, because I knew how cool that promo you sent in was. Yeah. And we were so excited. This is it, man. This is going to happen. But, man, it was such a bummer to see them on TV every week. I was like, oh, this sucks.
It was definitely a bummer. It was a downer. You know, but at that point, too, I was just like, okay, well, I guess I just need to pick up the pieces and move on. So I actually changed my name to Surge at that time, which it still allowed me to kind of do the same character. It was just a bit of a different name.
What? Oh, my! You gotta be kidding me! Things are about to be broken! Team Extreme is back! Matt and Jeff, the Hardy Boys are here!
Having these humble beginnings and having to have a full understanding of the way the wrestling business works, especially on my end, as far as making me a smarter performer, a smarter business person. It's helped give me longevity. It's helped in so many ways to just have a complete understanding of what I need to do to thrive and succeed in this industry. We busted our ass in places just like this and in armories and driving 12, 13 hours up and down the East Coast. And that was all in hopes and aspirations of fulfilling our dream of becoming WWE superstars. And we achieved that. And then, you know, we leave and you see these guys go through ups and downs and you see them, you know, have issues and you see them mature and you see them change and grow. And then, like, the storybook ending, I think, was coming back at WrestleMania 33. And it's like, wow, they're back home and they win the tag team titles, their initial gold one more time. Everything's come full circle. But also with that being a fairy tale ending, it's also like the very beginning of a new story. And I'm just so excited with the story because I think it's going to be the greatest one yet.